toda la afición de la lucha libre. Este que les habla es Michael Morales Torres, integrante del equipo de Lucha Libre Online. Y tenemos el honor de presentarles a nuestro invitado en la tarde de hoy, directamente de representando a India para el mundo. Él es The Desi Hitman and your X-Division Champion, Rohit Raju. Rohit, how are you doing today, sir?
Great, fantastic. I woke up as X-Division Champion. I can't ask for much more than that, right?
Yeah, man, and specifically we wanted to speak about that, and we can start the interview with that. You won the X Division Champion last Tuesday on Impact Wrestling's Emergence against TJP and Chris Bay in an amazing match. You were the underdog. No one was expecting Rohit to get the title. Fortunately, you did everything as planned, and your plan went perfect. You are now the X Division Champion. How does it feel to have the title with you, and in your opinion, if this is the highest point in your 12-year career?
As of right now, yes, it is. When I first started Impact, I didn't have any fanfare when I came in. I wasn't an indie name or anything of that nature. I didn't know anybody. I just won the gut check challenge. Even before that, I had just got thrown a bone and, hey, we had an opportunity for you. Come put in some work. So it was weird. There was no buildup for me when I came in. I was pretty much a mechanic. I was learning as I went, trying to get comfortable in the environment. So getting the X Division title, it was something I always wanted, but I never thought the upper management saw me as, you know what I mean? I never thought they recognized the hard work that I was putting in. Apparently they did. When it actually happened, I thought it was a rib. I didn't think it was real at all. I was like, there's no way this is, they're just messing with me. So when it happened, it made me feel great. And then when I watched it Tuesday on Twitch and it actually happened, I got super like just excited and overwhelmed with emotion. I couldn't believe that it actually happened. So it was great, man. It's honestly, it's one of the best feelings ever. And I love it. Absolutely love it.
And it was an amazing match for our Spanish-speaking fans. I want to mention something. Impact Wrestling va a tener el evento Emergence este próximo martes 25 de agosto. En este caso, la entrevista se está grabando hoy. Sería mañana, martes 25 de agosto. Disponible en Twitch y en Access TV. Pueden ver los mejores talentos de Impact. Va a haber una cartera bastante completa que va a estar siendo compartida en la página. Pero está en Twitch. twitch.com/impactwrestling y al igual que en Access TV. Rohit, you represent the country of India, which is an amazing country that's been seeing a growth, an incredible growth regarding pro wrestling fan base. The opposite basically to what's been happening in the United States and many other countries. But India, it's a country that people are consuming more pro wrestling, are more interested and are more committed to it at this point. What does it feel like to see the country you represent growing so fast in love for pro wrestling?
I love it. I absolutely love it. The fan base is great. I had trouble sleeping Tuesday, and so I was up pretty late, and then the Indian fans had got word of what was going on, so I had a flood in my DMs or inbox from fans just saying how happy they were, how proud they were that I was representing the country and that I won. And that's awesome. You know, and that's like such a great feeling. You can't, because it's bigger than right there. It's just bigger than just your feelings. So I think that's so cool. I want wrestling to continue to grow there. I know when Kali does shows over there, they have a ton of people. So I would love, once, you know, the whole pandemic is done and over with, I would love to travel and especially travel over there and wrestle in front of that crowd. I think it'd be, I just think it'd be unreal.
Awesome, man. We had the opportunity to spoke with Doug Gallows, and he described me a little bit the ambience backstage between co-workers. And at this point, Impact Wrestling is a huge family, but there's a reality, and everyone is hungrier than ever. You have a lot of people right now that may be interested, and they are highly probably interested in the X Division Champion. But outside of the ring, we've seen you recently with the North, for example, and a few guys sharing and vlogs and everything. How can you describe the ambience between co-workers at this point on Impact Wrestling?
When I first got there, it was very, very cliquish, and you had guys that were either former WWE guys or top guys or whatever, and they didn't give you the time of day. And I was just like, oh, wow, this is, you know, it's kind of what I thought it would be. And everybody was very, I guess they safeguarded their spot, or you had to earn the respect and stuff like that. As time went on, I feel like I obviously did. If you saw the outpour from my peers, which was absolutely amazing, this Tuesday and, you know, the following day, that was really cool. And things have changed. The locker room now is everyone pretty much gets along. You have people that hang out with each other more than they may hang out with somebody else. But all in all, everyone gets along and everyone's cool. Everybody wants to see the company grow. Everybody wants to see the company succeed and get better. So I think as far as the camaraderie in the locker room, it's never been better. So that's pretty cool. And I'm the type of person that I don't want to walk backstage and hear someone say, oh, yeah, the match was great or something like that. I want to know what was good and what was bad. And I can go to a few people and they'll break it down and give you that constructive criticism in a great way. And it's just, we want to see each other. We want to help each other out, but also we want our piece of the pie at the same time. So it works. It just works. I think we have one of the best locker rooms that I've ever been in.
Awesome. Regarding the creative process, specifically Ethan Page, EC3, and a few guys told us on an interview that Impact's creative process is freedom of giving the pro wrestlers the chance or the opportunity of being pro wrestlers, of doing what they love, of giving their thoughts on what their pitch. And we've known Scott D'Amore is popular on social media for hearing the fans. But as a pro wrestler employed by Impact Wrestling, how can you describe the creative process in the company at this point?
It's gotten a lot better. Again, when I first got there, I felt like it was all over the place. I wasn't a fan of what we were doing at the time, and it has grown, and it just gets better and better as time goes on. They do let you be you. As far as me, I like on the indies, I'm a little bit different. I'm just more of myself. Like Hakeem Zayn is something different that I do. Rohit represents India, so they kind of I don't want to say I'm in a box, but there are certain things they want me to do. And if my character is a certain way, they want me to do certain things. But usually at my promos, they let me say what I want. They give me some bullet points, but they let me get there how I want to. And our matches, the agents will give suggestions here and there, but they give us that creative freedom to go out there and do what we want. And that's great because it's organic. When you give someone that creative freedom, you're not reading a script or having to memorize certain things. It's just you going out there being you and having fun with it. So that's a huge, huge deal in my opinion. That makes your product that much more believable because you believe in it. It's not something you're trying to copy and paste. It's just something that comes natural to you, or it's something you'll say naturally. So then if you believe it and you're invested in it, everybody else around you is going to be invested in it. So in my opinion, it's the best way to go about creating something is, here's what we want, make it happen, do it how your character would do it. And then, okay, maybe they'll fine tune this, they'll fine tune that. But in my opinion, we're doing some of the best stuff right now, and I wish we would get more credit for it.
And I definitely agree with that. Impact has been it's been a crazy roller coaster ride in the last 5 years, but since Slammiversary specifically, everything is going up for the company, and everyone is loving what Impact does at this point. Specifically, the Latin American audience, many of them think that Impact is giving the best product in the whole wrestling industry right now. Speaking of the roster, I wanted to ask you: you are the X Division champion. That puts a huge target on your back. Do you have a specific wrestler you want to face from the roster or outside the roster, like Heath, who's legally not employed by Impact, has been mentioned multiple times on the Impact on Access TV weekly programming?
If Swan ever got healed up, I'd say Rich Swan. I've had some tag matches with him, and I thought there was some chemistry there, and I think he's amazing. Anybody in the X Division currently, and Jake Diener, Cousin Jake, that's who I would like. If I don't know if you're familiar with his outside stuff, he's tremendous. And I think that's a guy that, like me, just needs his shot, you know? He puts in hard work. and he gets overlooked by a lot of people. And there's certain things, like, it's funny because you see right now, I try not to pay attention to what the fans say too much, but my feedback so far has been pretty good as exhibition champion, but you got a lot of people are like, why is this jobber exhibition champion, or blah, 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 stuff like that. It's because there's a certain narrative when you're in the ring and you're losing. And that's the way the narrative that you're getting pushed in. Then all of a sudden out of the blue, it completely changes. People don't understand that, but people don't understand sometimes how good you really are, because that's not the focus. Sometimes you're in the ring to make other people look really good, but you're doing just as good as job, but you're not the priority at the time. I think Jake is one of those guys. And if you've ever seen him in his element, he's amazing. And anytime him and I get in the ring together, it's something special. We've known each other for years. So I would honestly love to defend the exhibition title against him and show everyone that doesn't know how good Cousin Jake is to see how good he is. Because there's a lot of people that don't realize how great this dude is. He's amazing.
Perfect, man. I wanted to say something in Spanish. Para todos nuestros seguidores, pueden seguir a Rohit Raju en Facebook como Rohit Raju, en Instagram como RajuZane80, en Twitter como HakimZane, al igual que pueden adquirir su mercancía en prowrestlingtees.com/Rohit. Pueden de igual manera adquirir la mercancía de Impact Wrestling en shopimpact.com. Pueden sintonizar la programación semanal de Impact a través de Access TV, a través de Pluto TV y de igual manera a través de Twitch, que es uno de los mecanismos más seguros a nivel mundial. Y definitivamente no pueden perderse Emergence mañana. Tenemos a Diona Purazzo enfrentándose a Jordynne Grace. Eddie Edwards con su reto abierto. Tenemos a Brian Myers enfrentándose a Willie Mack. ¿Qué pasará con EC3? ¿Regresará Heath? ¿Aparecerá Rohit nuevamente en Impact esta semana? No lo sabremos, pero tienen que sintonizarlo mañana en Emergence para poder saberlo a través de Twitch y Access TV. Rohit, it's been such an honor to have you as our guest. I thank you for your time, and I also thank the Impact Wrestling crew for making this possible. Last but not least, what message can you send to all the Spanish-speaking fans that are listening to you right now in order for them to follow the current product of Impact Wrestling, and maybe people who lose faith on the pro wrestling industry in general can come back in order to put eyes on the current product of Impact?
Well, first of all, I want to say I can't wait for all this to be done so we can come back to Mexico. I love wrestling in Mexico City. I love just walking around in Mexico City, seeing all the walking into like the lucha stores. I actually bought there's a pair of gold boots back there that I got from MTZ Wear, and we walked there and I bought them and I was so happy. And I love the boots and I wear them for special occasions. And maybe I'll wear them for Bound for Glory, we'll see. But I do miss wrestling in front of that crowd. That crowd is so passionate and they love wrestling. And when you're putting on a match there, they are invested in it. They boo, they cheer. I miss that. I definitely miss Mexico. But don't give up on professional wrestling. Don't give up on it. There's something for everybody, especially with Impact. Don't sleep on us. I think we've been putting out a great product. People still want to hang on to the past. We're not that organization anymore. We're totally different. Tune in. Give us a chance. Check us out. And I guarantee you are going to be pleased, at least with 85-90% of it. You might not like everything, but you'll like the majority of it because our roster right now is killing it, and I'll put us up against anybody.
Excelente, Rohit. Thank you so much for your time. A todos nuestros fanáticos, no olviden sintonizar Emergence mañana a las 8 de la noche, hora del este, 7 de la noche, hora Ciudad de México, a través de Access TV y Twitch. Seguimos con ustedes.